Hi, I'm Palab. I'm one of the subject matter experts here at Chegg.
Supply elasticity touches on similar themes as demand elasticity, only from the producer's point of view rather than the consumer's. Today, we will examine supply elasticity, what it looks like graphically, and what factors can affect it.
Elasticity of supply refers to percent change in quantity produced given percent change in price. A supply elastic good is where quantity supplied is very sensitive to the percent change in price. A supply inelastic good is one where quantity supplied does not change much regardless of changes in price. Graphically, elasticity can be shown as a movement along the supply curve. For a typical good, as the price rises, producers aim to produce more, as shown by the diagonal movement along the supply curve from point A to B. Gasoline is an example where the quantity supplied is responsive to price. When the price of oil increases, producers increase production and try to lock in those prices on the commodities market. Conversely, when the price of oil decreases, producers can collude to produce less in order to push up the price of oil at a future date. A good can be described as supply inelastic when the quantity supplied does not change even when the price moves significantly. One example of a supply inelastic good could be sold out concert tickets. Even with higher prices, more tickets cannot be supplied if the venue is already full. Supply elasticity can be affected by a number of factors, including marginal cost, competition, and time horizon. First, let's look at marginal cost. Sometimes a good's cost curve is not linear, and the marginal production of a good becomes more expensive over time. Let's say in a given market, the crypto coin sells for $5. For firm A, it cost $1 to produce the first crypto coin. But due to increasing energy and processing power, it costs $10 to produce the second crypto coin. Even if the price of a crypto coin rises to $7 from its original price of $5, it does not make economic sense for the firm to produce additional crypto coins since the marginal cost of producing the second doing exceeds the price consumers are willing to pay for it, and the supplier would be losing money. Competition is another factor in determining supply elasticity. The larger a producer is in a given market, the less supply elastic its products can become. Take railways for example. In many countries, railways are wholly or partially nationalized, which means that they are publicly owned and the government is usually one of the few or even the sole providers of services, a monopolist structure. If demand increases in a monopolist industry, a sole producer in an industry can make more profit by raising prices and keeping supply fixed. In a competitive market, higher prices come at the cost of market share for the firm, so a firm may choose to supply more instead of increasing prices. Time horizon is another useful factor in determining supply elasticity. In the short run, supply tends to be inelastic as producers struggle to expand production in a short period. Eventually, producers gravitate towards price trends and alter their production accordingly. Take the fashion industry as an example. Say, flat jeans become a summer trend and increase in price. Initially, some fashion suppliers are committed to fixed seasonal design production schedules without anticipating the higher price for flared jeans. Over time, though, some fashion producers can more easily adapt to higher prices and produce more trendy clothes. Supply elasticity is a critical concept to grasp, especially from the producer's perspective. This is why it is important to know what it is, what it looks like graphed out, and what other factors affect it. If you want to learn more, come visit us at Chegg, where you can see solutions that you have already worked out, or ask for help directly from one of the Chegg subject matter experts.